I work all day and get half drunk at night. Waking at four to soundless dark, I stare. In time, the curtain edges will grow light. Till then, I see what's always really there. Unresting death. The mind blanks at the glare. Not in remorse. The good not done, the love not given. Time torn off, unused. But at the total emptiness forever. The sure extinction that we travel to and shall be lost in always. Not to be here, not to be anywhere. And soon, nothing more terrible, nothing more true. This is a special way of being afraid. No trick dispels. Religion used to try. That vast moth-eaten musical brocade created to pretend we never die. And specious stuff that says no rational being can fear a thing it will not feel. Not seeing that this is what we fear. No sight, no sound, no touch or taste or smell. Nothing to think with, nothing to love or link with. The anesthetic from which none come round. And so it stays just on the edge of vision, a small unfocused blur, a standing chill that slows each impulse down to indecision. Most things will never happen. This one will.
Thank you. as it were, the noise of thunder. One of the four beasts saying, "Come and see." And I saw, and behold, a white horse.
Thank you. Amazing. Amazing.
Thank you. touch. You've given me too much to feel. Sweet touch. You've almost convinced me I'm real. I need something more. I need something more.
We met in the springtime when blossoms unfold. The pastures were green and the meadows were gold. Our love was in flower as summer grew on. Her love, like the leaves, now have withered and gone. The roses have faded, there's frost at my door. The birds in the morning don't sing anymore. The grass in the valley is starting to die. And out in the darkness the whippoorwills cry. Alone and forsaken by fate and by man. Oh Lord, if you hear me, please hold my hand. Oh, please understand. Oh, where has she gone to? Oh, where can she be? She may have forsaken some other like me. She promised to honor, to love and obey. Each vow was a plaything that she threw.